Good morning, guys. Let's continue with my series of random old tools. And this one is a little bit different. I've got a couple of modified tools that I have over the years that I've done, and I still keep it. Let's start with this one. This is a number 10 spanner that I bent like this. And if I remember right, I've had to do this for the tappet cover nuts on the golf ones. There's one nut that you had to bend it like this to get it off nice. Otherwise, you have just a little bit of, at the angle actually, that you just a little bit can work with it. So if you do this, it worked very nice. So I haven't got a golf one anymore, but this is one of my modified tools. And then I've got a number 11 that I had to make thinner. I think, if I remember right, this was for some work on one of my lawn tractors. I think it was to remove the starter. But I'm not 100% sure anymore, but I remember I had to grind it off for a thin area to go in and to grab a number 11 nut. Okay, so this is where it came from, also old. And then I modified this number 14. This I use still today on my angle grinder. This is to lock the shaft underneath the disc. My machine haven't got a lock that you press. I believe there was a spanner that is gone that worked in conjunction with this. This grab the disc or the nut on top, and this go in from the underneath. And there's no space there. I need to make it thinner so that I can grab the axle. So this is where this worked today. And it came a long way, I think from the 2000s. And then I've got a screwdriver that I modify like the tip like this. I had something, appliance one day that I had to open, and it have that strange little screws with web in the middle, and that is what I use it for, to open that strange little screws. Okay, and then at one time I had to make myself a quick punch to get in, but it was I was restricted by the length, so normal punch wouldn't work. So I just take a piece of material and make a quick punch for that, and it does its job, and I still got it in my special collection of special tools. And this I believe it's a number 8 Allen key that I modified this tip on this side. You can see it's smaller. If I remember right, this is now a number 7. This is for the also on the Golf 1. If you have to remove the McPherson struts in front, if you want to remove the shock absorber inside the spring, you open your bonnet, and where your shock comes through the body, you grab it in the middle with this number 7, and then you can unscrew the big bolt or nut. So this is what I make it myself, so it worked for that. I could not get a number 7 at that point, and I make myself one, so I still got it. And then not long ago, before I have my Dremel set, I had to polish something, and I haven't got a small material polisher, and I made one, take a screw and put layers of material on top of each other, and it works well for what I wanted to do. You can see there's still some polish on. So this is just a homemade polisher that still can work. Okay, and then at one time, I can't remember what was the story, but I need to go in and punch something out. And here I was really restricted, and I took this Allen key and I had to make it a little bit thinner there as well. You can see I had to make it a little bit thinner with a little sharp point just to get in somewhere and punch it out. It was a little bit difficult job, as I remember right, but it does its thing, and I still got it till today. Okay, and the next item is very useful. My Farmall plugs is bigger than the normal plugs, and I haven't got a plug spanner for it. So, and the Lister as well, they take the same size plug, and I take this fairly cheap type, and I just stretch it out to grab that bigger plugs. So this I use still, and I make this when I get the Farmall, which was about in 2015-16 there around. So I still use it. And not a modified item, but show me an Allen key that is closer to break off than this one. It sit on a hair there, guys. So I just stop in time for it to look like this. I just keep it as a remembrance of something that gives me grief in the past. Okay, and then I thought I'd throw this as my smallest shifting spanner. It is a Curzon. I don't know where it came from, but what is interesting for me, I don't know where it came from, where I get it, but I have it a long time. But what is interesting, you see there's a crack, and I check it out. Somebody use it at a point for a spacer or something, and he slam it there. You can just see there, somebody hit it there with something, and it cracked the whole thing. But it still works. I didn't use it much, but it's still in a working order. Very nice little tool. Okay, and then just something interesting. This is, I've seen the name somewhere. This is a set. I'll show you quickly. I don't know where it came from, but it's very interesting. It got this, a couple of points like this. And let's take one. They all look the same. You will put it in there and screw this on. And then you've got this kind of a screwdriver. It got a name somewhere, but I can't see it now. Or maybe there is no name. Okay, but it's it got this pieces also. Something old. And the last item is just for an interesting sake. It's a nice little grease gun that works like that. And it got a name. It is made in England. It is a Tecklemit. It is a Tecklemit made in England. Just an interesting little grease gun. Okay, my friends, and then my brother let me know, according to the tracking number of the special package that he sent me from the north of South Africa. It is now in, or yesterday it was in Pretoria, and it's now on its way to Cape Town. So I believe it will be here earlier than the 2nd of May. Probably, I believe I will. It will be here Monday or Tuesday. Let's hope so. Then it will be interesting mail call there with that new old item and some other goodies that he sent me. Okay, my friends, see you now on the next one, and hope you like and subscribe and ring the bell for not missing any new videos. Cheers, bye-bye.